even Governor Asa Hutchinson. Jay Bird joining us now live with more on what the governor had to say about that today. Jay.
Yeah, you could say he was a little shocked when even he fell victim to this scheme. And officials are saying basically what the idea is that somebody will use someone else's identity in order to file a claim. But the state is saying that they are also seeing that they're hoping, just with the pure volume of claims, is that they are hoping, these fraudsters are hoping that they can just slip through the cracks. But state trying to be proactive.
The state of Arkansas has been dealing with unemployment fraud on a large scale for a few weeks now, and it has affected some of the legitimate claims trying to be made.
Unfortunately, like I said, sometimes they are legitimate claims that are getting held up, but in an abundance of caution that we don't want to pay out fraudulent claims.
Officials say that anyone can have this happen. Teachers, state workers, even the governor himself has had his name used to file a fraudulent claim.
And I have a notice of determination of entitlement under the CARES Act to a pandemic unemployment assistance payment that I have been approved for.
The Department of Commerce says they have frozen 27,000 claims in the pandemic unemployment assistance system and 10,000 in the unemployment system to make sure everything is on the up and up, because it could cost the state twofold.
Because one, we don't want to pay fraud to pay claims to those who are fraudsters who have claimed it. The other side is that if we pay that, when the federal government comes back and does an audit on the state and our unemployment system, all those fraudulent claims that we paid out, we'll have to then reimburse the federal government.
The Department of Commerce is even soliciting other departments to help with identification verification, and they hope that they can clear out the bad accounts sooner rather than later.
As you can see, it's a wide-scale issue for not only Arkansas, but across many states. We want to make sure that we're doing everything that we can to combat fraud.
Now, the Department of Commerce will be sending out verification letters to those PUA beneficiaries, and they're asking that those beneficiaries take that letter physically and other forms of identification to one of the verification stations that the Department of Commerce will be setting up across the state. And they also encourage anyone that has fell victim to this to make sure to file a police report. And we're actually going to hear much more on this topic coming up tonight at 10, as our Alexis Wainwright is actually going to be talking with a family who fell victim to this very exact scheme. But for now, live from the state capitol, Jay Burt, KRK 4 News.
Cal, one of the last things people need to deal with right now, Jay. Thanks very much.